Here at Florida State, I teach in the LL.M program, both courses that appeal to students who are interested in the domestic law of the United States, and those primarily focus on intellectual property. So, for example, this semester I'm teaching a course in patent law, which is a course that, among other things, would help students get ready to practice before the patent bar at the U.S. Patent and Trademark Office in Washington, D.C. But my principal focus is in international law, and I offer a range of courses that deal with different subject matters that are maybe of particular interest to students who are interested in entering a global practice after they get their LLM. So, for example, I teach a class in international trade law, and that course focuses on the law of the World Trade Organization, the law of various regional organizations, goes into quite a bit of work on dispute settlement and how to approach litigation at the international level. We talk a lot about trade remedies, such as anti-dumping and countervailing duty proceedings, and so forth. And also, to a certain extent, how the United States approaches these areas, which even for students from abroad might be something of particular interest. For example, if they were working in their government in the foreign trade field, their government would be interested in how the U.S. approaches international trade regulation and negotiations at the international level. I teach a course called International Aspects of Intellectual Property Law. I'm the author of the course book with the current Director General of the World Intellectual Property Organization and a senior faculty member at the World Trade Institute in Bern, Switzerland. And there we cover the panoply of intellectual property rights, patent, trademark, copyright, and so forth, and how those intellectual property rights are registered and maintained at the international level. And we also do quite a bit of work about intellectual property policy, and in particular, how intellectual property law affects developmental interests and affects transfers of technology in and to developing countries and developed countries. That's a fairly comprehensive course. Another course that I teach that reflects a great deal of work that I do at the international level is a seminar on global regulation of the pharmaceutical sector. And in that course, we talk about the importance that the pharmaceutical industry has, the role the pharmaceutical industry has in addressing public health needs, particularly in developing countries and developed countries. Pharmaceutical regulation is extraordinarily complex. Subject matter dealing with all facets from research and development through manufacturing and production and distribution and procurement. And medicines are obviously very important to maintaining public health. A good deal of the work I've done internationally has to do with how we secure both research and development, but also low-cost access to medicines for developing countries. So I've done, over the years, a good deal of work with governments of developing countries and the World Health Organization in creating programs to furnish lower-cost access and improved access to medicines throughout the world. So those are the four areas of courses that I'm currently teaching, and they're all things that I think are of potentially great interest to LLM students attending FSU's LLM program. So I've done a good deal of work over the years in Latin America. I've been to most every country in Latin America. I've worked both closely with governments on developing their regulatory policies and their trade policies in this area, and most of it devoted to the ultimate objective of how do we improve public health and access to pharmaceutical products and vaccines throughout Latin America, but it's also work I do internationally. I've done a good deal of work in Africa on these access to medicines issues, as well as a good deal of work in Asia, including both in India and China and so forth. And it's quite a very interesting area, but it's also an area, the area of pharmaceuticals, whether a student wants to go to work for a major pharma company, a government, a generic company, or an NGO, the ways in which the regulatory structure are developed and implemented around the world are very important to becoming a successful lawyer in this area, and are indeed an extraordinarily complex integrated system when taken all together. So hopefully I and we as Florida State can bring to students a very practical, real-world understanding of how this complex regulatory structure works and the type of things that they might be able to eventually use in either their practice or their work in governments from a regulatory standpoint.